So the second part of our workshop will be about actually the API of Selenide. So let's go through the topics one by one. We will probably not start any code or just start a bit of examples because it will take too much time. Okay, so but all of these examples are already in on GitHub. You will get a link on one of the slides, so you can just download it and try it yourself. They should be working. You can experiment with them. Yes. So the first topic is the selectors, selector examples. So Selenide basically reuse selectors of Selenium, which you may know. It's XPath, ID, link text, partition, link text, name, class name. And the most used selector in Selenium is CSS selector. So it is made default in Selenide. So if you just use a dollar sign and CSS selector, that it would be considered CSS selector and used as it. So we have additional selectors with Selenide, which helps in many cases. So they are probably the most popular is by text selector, which is which you could not only click on something which is a link by link text, but any text, basically any text. And by text is exact. The text must be exact. It's not the partial text. And with text, do the second possibility is to use the partial text. Text. You can find element by its attribute, and it's default for just by attribute name, attribute value. It's absolutely the same. And you, if you have more than one element which is found by selector, you can use the second parameter of. For example, here CSS selector index starts with zero, so it's the third element. A few more is by title and by value, which are kind of redundant because you can. It's an example. The selectors by name, by title, by value, by ID, by class name can be described as CSS selector very easily. I mostly use CSS selector just not to mix the thing up. Here you can see examples which are exact the same as these selectors. Yes, in Selenide you can use a chain selector. This one means that you search. At first one container, a div.container, and then inside this container you are searching for a button buy. So if you have many button buys on the page, then you can localize your search more effectively. And I want to mention that this dollar element itself, it doesn't search anything. It doesn't start a search. It's just defined in the element. It's very important. It's a mistake that some beginners are making. So this invalid selector doesn't fail in because it's basically just a definition. It's not execution. So it is executed if you do a click or you do any of shoots. Statements or do any action of this these elements, and even if you change the elements, there are still no search is executed. So you can search is executed just in time when you call in the action or doing your assertions. Another synonym for this second dollar sign is find. Don't know. There are some people who prefer to use find if it is more readable for them. And even this find doesn't search. Now it's good documented, but I know some of the beginners thought that this find actually executes the search. And there are some extra navigating methods like parent and closest DOM tag. It's similar as in jQuery to navigate through the tags. Okay, so it's a topic of finding the elements. So let's go to the next topic. Next topic will be assertion and condition. This is probably the most important part of Selenide. Okay. So, just in general, every shoot is an assert. I had recently heard a question if shoots are better than asserts or not. Shoots, every shoot is an assert. So it's definitely an asset. It's it checks some data, but it has some features which make it this shoots a very good tool for your tests. It's first of all, it waits for its condition. So if you are ascertain if element is visible, if element has any text, and the condition is not true right now, then any Selenium test will automatically wait this configuration time out of milliseconds. It's per default is 4 seconds. It's pretty good value for the most project, but you can reconfigure it for your own project as you wish. And if the condition is not met, then this failing procedure is started. So it will take Selenide text screenshot, it saves source code, and it outputs meaningful debugging information, which we have seen already in the first part of our workshop. So there are some examples of simple and the most popular shoots condition. It is should be visible, should have text, or should appear. Appear and the visible are the same. It's just the synonyms. And every shoot, every positive and every negative shoot are equivalent among each other. So it's just the same code. It's done to get the English semantic language semantic better. So better, so you can. Write your test in human language. So the negative variance that should be hidden, it's opposite of visible, or should not have some text, or should not exist. Okay, a few more shoots is that you can change the shoot, so should be visible, should have text, and so on. You can just have more than one condition in the same shoot statement. So you can write should have text Angular and CC class doc logotype. You can use a few of words like have text Angular and not be hidden. So it also it doesn't make any magic, but it is easier, just made to allow you to enable you to write tests that are better readable for human being. There is a possibility to use or and predicates, but I must say so. And predicate is basically redundant because you could just do it comma separated. It's absolutely the same, and you should so the or selector. So it should be either visible or I don't know hidden. It will never work, but you have very seldom. The test that should have be one of two different conditions, but probably there are cases where you need it, so you have this possibility in Selenide. Visibility condition explained. Once more, visible is the same as appear. exist is which I also probably not use very often in my test, because this check asks if the element is existing in DAW, but it could be visible or invisible. So for normally for human being, he cannot understand it from the page if the element is there or not. But there are probably some kind of technical test where it should be this could be useful. Okay. Hidden is either invisible on the page in the DOM on the page, but invisible, or doesn't exist anymore, and this disappear is just a synonym of it. So text conditions examples, you can the standard by for Selenide is case insensitive and partial match. So here we have text Angular. And we are checking, you see it's partial match and it's case insensitive, so it will pass. This is the case sensitive, but still partial match test. And this exact test, because it's actually, that's what you have on your page, Angular material. And there are, as you can see, all four possibilities for looking for the right test, yes. And you also have a match text which use a regular expression, so you could use some pretty complex expressions to compare. Okay, and a few of other conditions. It's attribute. It checks if the attribute is right. This attribute without has the right value, and this attribute without the second parameter is just make sure that attribute is existing. So not every attribute has value at all. Yes, CC class is rather popular to check if element is styled right. For inputs, you have disabled, enabled, and empty. That means no value in it. And it's also a value is then value of a text field is standard is partial match, and if you have if you must compare to exact value, then you have exact value comparator, and a few others. So type ID and name they are redundant. You could use as attribute with attribute selector as well. Okay, next topic. Let's see about checkboxes. Checkboxes, radio box, are typical elements of the page. So you must know that the checkbox method and radio and drop downs will work in this way only well only if you have the very basic standard HTML elements. So if it input input of type checkbox. Nowadays many frameworks are generating checkbox, radio box, and drop downs with HTML code, which actually is not more this standard HTML code. So the most of this method will not work, but it's not a problem, because if you are writing test with Selenide, you should not think about the type of the element, but you should just like human being, you should locate element and click at it and locate element and check his property. If it is in most cases, if it is visible or is it is, if it is on or off or have some text. So the click method and a special condition for checkboxes is of course checked. It could be true or false. And you can set with set selected, you can set it for true, and false you can set it for false, independent of in which state it is now. It's radio box. it's not easy to find a good page where radio boxes are still used, but for our luck, eBay has some have some pages where they use radio boxes. I think I will not go in this code showing you the example on the page, but it's commented here. It's a value of radio box. So you can you locate your radio box combination and select the radio. But as I've already said, the old-fashioned radio box are almost out of the most of the contemporary projects. And it just works the same way with asserting the value. Dropdowns is also the same way. We can check if it's enabled or disabled. You could disable some of the items in your dropdown. You can check it, and you have a few options to select the right option from your dropdown. It could be by text, by partially text, or by index, or by value which is written in HTML code. And you can easily assert the text and the value of the dropdowns in this field. And it's an interesting thing. So input is basically very simple. You're using set value to set this value, and you can assert this. But we have two mode in Selenide. So this fast set value false is default. It's this configuration uses just standard send key method of Selenium, which actually fails in some situations. So if you have problems, perhaps some of you have seen that your test don't write the full text in your input fields. I've seen it with Firefox, I think 1 year ago, multiple times. So just set value long text, and it cut it somewhere for no apparent reasons, sometimes in different places, but probably some action handlers on the page which don't interact right with send key method of Selenium. So we have this trick with Selenide. You can set this option for true, and I recommend you to use it in the most of the cases. If you don't care for just really typing each of your letters one by one, it first of all it works more fast than this traditional one, because it's just a short JavaScript injection that just set the whole value in your field. And secondly, it makes your test in cases which I've mentioned more stable. Okay? So, mouse actions. Next topic. It's pretty simple. We have click and context click, which is the same as right click, double click and hover. Without need to use any long action build performance unnecessary, but under the hood, of course, we are using this because it's the standard way the Selenium does it. We have drag and drop, which is sadly doesn't work with HTML5, but not because of Selenide, but because of Selenium. The bug is at the moment open. Selenium cannot drag and drop HTML5 draggable elements at the moment. And we have some methods to help you to scroll to elements, and you can still use actions to compose these complicated more complicated cases where you could just navigate your mouse at some custom offset, it's like kind of drag and drop here implemented. And of course, you can use also some special case. I don't know, we have it's more time. If it's quarter after. Okay. Ah, okay. It's strange. Okay, so collections. Collection examples. Double dollar sign is Selenium way to search and collect more than one element. So element collection is iterable, you can iterate through it. So you probably don't need to iterate it, through it the most of the time. And of the same way as a dollar doesn't start any search, double dollar doesn't start any search too. So you must use some commands to initiate the search. So you can use all the same selectors as you can as you use with single dollar command. So you can do a typical operation like filter with filter or it's opposite of filter, so all except with this text. Yes, you can get the first, last, and indexed element of the collection. And you can find by text, which were pretty slow in the earlier versions of Selenide, because it it's iterated through the whole collection just to find the first element. Now it works much faster, so now you can use it. And so here's some examples of what is returned in the collection. Even if your collection is just a single element, the collection will be returned. Empty collection will be returned if nothing is found, so no errors. And if you use get or find methods, that are the methods which are returning Selenide element. It's now as collections has their own assertions. It at the moment it's a bit less of conditions that you could use for assertion with collection. It's empty size with some different possibilities, and size could be greater, less than, and not equal. So probably very seldom needs something like this. And all text assertions are case sensitive, and you can search for text and for exact text, and we don't have at the moment any possibility to search in the collection if the order of element or the number of element is not the same as in a searchable collection. So it would always fail if your collection has two elements and you are searching for just one text. Okay, but it can be that we will change it in the next versions. Okay, so we are going to some advanced topics. Hopefully, we will. Okay. Okay, 10 minutes were shown, and I was pretty nervous. Okay, but. Okay, so waiting. What I wanted to tell you about waiting is that unfortunately many test developers were forced into thinking that weights of web elements in standard Selenium test is normal. For me, it's not, because actually, if you are testing the site of testing some sites manually, you never think of loading of element of typical loading, which is done in a second or perhaps a few seconds. You don't think about it like waiting. But there are, of course, situations where you wait. The typical examples are upload of files or download of files or a search operation, which really takes time. Then you can, as a tester, you can really understand, okay, here I am waiting. And that is the only case you should use this waits command. Commands, it's like similar to explicit wait for in Selenium, and you can here just define how much time are you going to wait. So if you have some upload, you in some cases you can wait for 30 seconds or even a few minutes, and it's all right. It's not a problem with your test, but there are some flows that takes time. So normally you just don't use any waits. Just you should configure your timeout to be acceptable for your project, for most of your tests not to fail because of random connectivity problems. If you are testing a living application, there's never 100% guarantee that every request will be returned in a proper amount of time. So if you are frequently executing your test, you will always have from time to time cases where just some element appeared not after 4 seconds but after 5 seconds. So you should just adjust your standard timeout to your acceptable value, and it's fine. Okay. So that's a typical use of waits. Wait until and wait while is the opposite of wait until. So it's waits. It waits when the element is hidden and stops waiting after that. And if timeout is reached, then the test fails with exception, screenshot, and so on. So this example is example of failing timers. You can start it and see that the assertion error will be thrown, and it will be managed. Okay. Okay. File uploads and downloads are done very easily in Selenide. Oops. Okay. So it's as simple as this, and it does work out of the box from remote web for remote web driver and for local web driver. You just find the element and you use download method that will be downloaded to a file. Yes, if the file is not on the server, so it returns for example 404 exception, then the file not found exception will be thrown, so you can also handle it some way. Okay, upload files is also very simple. So you have two ways how to you prepare your files. You can either read it from your file system, and the second way is to put it in class pass of your project. It's normally for example for Maven and Gradle project, it resources folder in your test folder. Yeah, so it works automatically, and then you just use the upload method, and this method doesn't do any uploading because the standard controls not upload the files directly, but normally you should press some buttons at the end to start uploading. So please don't forget it. There's always an upload button somewhere. Okay, so JavaScript. Okay. You can easily execute JavaScript with Selenide. It's actually the same methods that you would use in Selenium. It's just some examples that you show you that you can you execute JavaScript. In this example, close the arrays with single command from Selenide. And these examples where you could use the parameters in your JavaScript, and this JavaScript returns something back. So, but it's basically the same methods which also Selenium has. And we have some extra methods which help you to gather JavaScript errors from your actually from your application. It's normally not. It's normally used for technical tests. So, it just a few extra assets. You can ask your browser if there are not some hidden exceptions that it could help you to analyze and find some hidden problems. So probably the test runs well and everything looks good, but if you have exceptions and errors in your log, it's a sign that probably something went wrong, and it's nice to check it once in a while. Okay. And the next topic, I would like to do a running presentation. So the next topic is the cloud services. What do you think, how much code should we change to make this test execute on one of the cloud service? So the answer is zero. We don't change our code at all. We just use some parameters, and so the first basic step is to configure it with remote parameter of Selenide where your remote server is located. So it could be as well your local, local Selenium grid for your project. It could be any server who is running Selenium server, yes, or it could be cloud servers. For example, it's browser stack. You get this URL if you register at the site, and there will be some passwords and keys generated, so you will get just this line, you copy it, and it will work. And we will add here just a few capabilities to manage in which with which platform, which browser, and which system we are going to run it. So I will try to run it. Gradle test, for example, just one. I don't want to run all the tests, but just checkbox tests. You'll see. So that's debug information. Will be common right now. As you can see, it's detected already that it is running on Windows and Firefox 45. We don't see any browser here because it is running online on the servers. And if we have luck, okay, that's our run. And this service also automatically records a video for you. So you can see how did it work. So it's a very easy and convenient way to start your test in different browsers on different systems without needing to set up any infrastructure at all. And as you can see, you don't even need to change your test for it in Selenide. It's pretty nice. Okay. So, We have three more examples. I will just skip very quickly through them. One is soft assets. If you know it, sometimes it's nice to have a possibility to make all the checks before the test fails. A standard behavior in JUnit to fail after the first fail. So just a few lines of code, rule, and configure the assert to be soft, and then this test will run. And it will gather all the failures, and it will run until the end, or until you reconfigure it back to strict mode. And it's useful for many situations. And two other examples: profiling. Sometimes you want to understand why are your tests so slowly. What takes time? So it's just one line of code in Selenide, rule text report. And you will get. I will try to execute it. Execute it, and you will get profiling information on your test. So, just want to show it shortly. Yes. So it's you have table and milliseconds how long did every operation take. So you could probably find your bottlenecks, which selector are too slow, just using this one line of code, which is pretty nice, I think. Okay, and the last example will be video recorder. Okay, it reminds me of that I need to uncomment this, and you just need to do additional step. You should add one more dependency. It's because this framework is just an external component from Sergei Pirogov, Automation Remarks Video Recorder. We add the dependency, and we just do some inputs. Okay, I think I will not start it this time because it takes time. So you must include video rule in your class, and then you can put a video annotation to the test, which is which should be recorded. And default behavior is that a video is written only, is saved only if your test fails. So it doesn't create much of your space. But of course, you never know from the beginning if test fails. So it does recording. Yes, it was always recorded, but will be saved only if test fails. And this. This is a link. So this is the state of now. It could change, but there is a good documentation. About the link, you can see all the options you can use. You can, of course, you can record all the tests. Independent if it fails or not. Okay, so it's also, so as you can see, Selenide is very good pluggable, so you can very easily use also other tools or small libraries with it. I think it's another benefit of using Selenide. So we have five more minutes, and it's the last few slides. It's frameworks which we used Selenide with, but actually Selenide is not limited to particular kinds of framework. It just you can use it testing your applications that are written with basically every framework, JavaScript or PHP or Java, it doesn't matter at all. Every web application. And you could write Selenide code in Groovy and Kotlin as well. directly because, okay, of course, it's Java-based languages. And known issues as of now, large collection could be small because if you have like many columns and many lines, if you want to filter it, then it probably will load all this data. So in some cases, it is better to find alternatives like XPath expressions to get the data you need. There are some collection assertions missing at the moment, and multi-browser test not officially supported. To this, I've thought until now that you cannot start a test which opens two different browser and doing some action in one browser and the second browser. But I've recently heard that it's actually can be done with a small extension of Selenide. So you must not change the Selenide code, but you should extend one of its classes, and it works. But it's not for sure. It's just some rumors. We will test it. And okay. As Selenide site has this sentence on its page: poor software doesn't have documentation, brilliant software doesn't need documentation. I'm sorry, it looks that this is not right. Now we see, we have seen how our users write Selenide test, and now we understand we need documentation. And this workshop is done also with the goal that it's like basic documentation, because I have seen you can use Selenide in very bad and perverted manner. And I think the main reason is because documentation is unfortunately not as good. But we have started Git book. It's open and it's work in progress. So you should look up if there is some new information. I think it will be ready in a few months, so the user could read it. And yes, okay, that's Git book, and Git book search for Selenide. It's everything is pretty straightforward, like everything in Selenide. And the problem was that we didn't have any official support. So we have reacted sometimes quickly on problems, but you never had a guarantee that your problem will be solved, or even if you have your answer. And now, starting from March, we are offering enterprise support. So if your companies are interested, we can make service level agreement, and you will get your problem solved. So workshop code is available here. So you can just skim through the tests and try it out and change the code and look how it's working. And now we have perhaps a few minutes for questions. Okay, any questions? Everything is too simple to have any questions, yes? For me too.
Kind of maybe 5-4 window, and when test is over, Selenide close automatically.
Mm-hmm. The question was if Selenide automatically close the browser window. The Selenide close also automatically the browser window. You have an option to hold it open. There is an option. So I haven't shown you every single option. We never had a time for it. Yes. But it especially there is some code that helps to close the windows that sometimes doesn't close themselves. So it's not just browser quit. There are some tries if it doesn't actually quit to make it more stable. And it actually works in almost in every case. Okay, one question there. How does Selenide work with iframe? I've tried to avoid doing examples about it because frames and iframes are typically not easy to automate because of for me the problems with Selenide. With Selenium core code. So it is, I don't know exactly the reason, it is very slowly to switch between the frames. Selenide has a method. I can try to just type it here. Selenide switch to. And you have here a possibility to choose a window or frame using name, ID, as web element, so you can, of course, you can reach every frame and iframe, but this switching is slow. But it's you can do anything about it in the moment.
Very slow because I use it in my project very often. Very useful this one when you can. When you can send array of frames and you don't need to write a separate command for each frame. So you just can count it in one place and it's very easy for me.
I mean yes, slow it's relatively if you have many frames that are included in each other. Then you have real problem, and probably it is, I don't know, let's say it's half a second. Half a second is, if you do it once, if you have just one frame to change it, it's not big deal. If you, for every action, go in your frame and then back, it accumulates. But it's not, at the moment it's not a problem of Selenide. Okay, but the web application should not use frames. Okay, the time is out. Thank you very much.